Hi all, welcome back. This is lecture number 2. Here we are going to discuss again about the same technique but little modification. In the last lecture, I have attached some of the practice questionnaires there. If you have not gone through those questionnaires, please do go through. That will make you perfect with the technique that you have learned. And also you will find a need of new modification in that same technique, because it will not able to solve you some of your problems. So question number 5 and 10 we are solving here, which you could not have solved using the old technique. So the question goes like this: 85 into 93. So in this case, now if you see here, 85 is 15 less than 100 and 93 is 7 less than 100. So which makes it 15 into 7, 105, and 85 minus 7 or 93 minus 15, whatever it will give you 78. So is the answer 78105? Let's check out with the help of calculator. So 85 into 93, which gives us 7905. So of course our answer is wrong. So what went wrong here? What we should modify here? If you remember, I had told that our base is here, our base is 100. That means on the right hand side, whenever we multiply the numbers, these two numbers, when we are multiplying, we should get a number which is of 2 digits. It cannot be less than 2 digits or it cannot be more than 2 digits. But we have a case where we have a number more than 2 digits. Then what we should do? We should carry this number forward to this side, as we do in case of normal addition. So what happens here? The 1 comes to this side now. So this becomes 79 and right side becomes 05. So now the answer is correct. So when you have a higher number, that is not 2 digits number, and why we are trying to keep 2 digits on the right side? Because we have taken the base as 100, so we can keep 2 digits on the right side. We have to keep 2 digits on the right side. Similarly, when the base is 1000, that means 1 has 3 zeros, then we have to keep 3 digits on the right side, and the formula goes like that. So we can see the application of it in higher numbers. I will show you in the next lecture. So now this is very clear that since we got 105 on the right side, we took 1 as a carry forward to the left side of the number and added it to the number, and we got our answer. So with just a little bit of modification, we got our answer. Similarly, now let's say multiply 103 and 102. Here 103 I can write plus 3 and 102 I can write plus 2. So 3 2s is 6. 103 plus 2 is 105, or 102 plus 3 is also 105. So is the answer 1056? Of course it is not, because on the right side I told, since the base is 100, we have to keep 2 numbers, but we got only 1 number after multiplying 3 into 2. So we should put a 0 before this, and that's all is the answer, 10506. Let's check out. 103 into 102, so that gives 10506. So this is quite simple, and little bit of modification we are doing and getting the same answer or the same result we get in the very less time. So you might be thinking that why this modification is required, but just to give you an idea that how this technique works, you should just now try to remember the steps that we are following, which are really very simple, nothing complicated here. When I will explain you why this technique works or how this technique works, you will be really able to map that, why I am taking a carry forward to the other side, or why I am trying to add a 10 before a number if there is a less digited number is available on the right side. All this logic you will really come to know. To add some points here, if you extend this principle, actually you can do multiplication of very high numbers, which you really can, will take some long time if you do in a conventional way. In this multiplication itself, you can find out that you are saving a lot of time. Just think of a number where numbers are of 3 digits, 4 digits, or 5-digited numbers, and you will be really surprised to see doing this, following the same technique, and then doing it in a very less time. So we will discuss that in the next lecture. So stay tuned for the next lecture and do go through the practice session attached to it. Thank you.